बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। स्टूडेंट्स आई होप यू विल बी फाइन, स्टे होम एंड स्टे सेफ। माय नेम इज सर हारिस फ्रॉम बहरिया कॉलेज हनीफ कैंपस। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लेसन नंबर 3 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 10। चैप्टर नेम इज सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन एंड वेव्स। दिस लेसन फॉर क्लास 10 फेडरल बोर्ड। Topics of the lesson are wave motion and types of waves. After this lesson, student, you will be able to understand how to describe wave motion and the different types of waves and their definitions. Students, waves play an important role in our daily life, like radio waves. It is because waves are carrier of energy and information over large distances. Let's do some activity to demonstrate the production and propagation of different waves with the help of vibratory motion of the objects. Activity number 1. Waves produce by dipping a pencil in a water tub. Dip one end of pencil into a tub of water and move it up and down vertically. The disturbance in the form of ripples produces water waves which move away from the source. When the wave reaches a small piece of cork floating near the disturbance, it moves up and down about its original position, while the wave will travel outwards. The net displacement of the cork is zero. The cork repeats its vibratory motion about its mean position. Activity number 2. Waves produce in a rope. Take a rope and mark a point P on it. Tie one end of the rope with a support and stretch the rope by holding its other end in your hand. Now, flipping the rope up and down regularly will set up a waves in the rope which will travel towards the fixed end. The point P on the rope will start vibrating up and down as the wave passes across it. The motion of point P will be perpendicular to the direction of the motion of wave. After these simple activities, we can define wave as: a wave is a disturbance in the medium which causes the particle of the medium to undergo vibratory motion about their mean position in equal interval of times. There are two types of waves: mechanical waves, electromagnetic waves. Mechanical waves require a medium for their propagation. Mechanical waves are further divided into two types: longitudinal waves and transverse wave. Sound waves is the example of longitudinal waves. Water waves is the example of transverse waves. Electromagnetic waves do not require a medium for their propagation. Examples are light, microwaves, infrared, X-rays, ultraviolet rays, radio waves. Let's discuss longitudinal waves and transverse waves in details. longitudinal waves. Longitudinal waves can be produced on a spring or slinky fix one end of the slinky with a rigid support and hold the other end into your hand. Now give it a regular push and pulls in the direction of its length. A series of disturbance in the form of wave will start moving along the length of the slinky. In longitudinal waves, the particles of the medium move back and forth along the direction of propagation of wave. It consists of compression and rarefaction. Compression is the region where loops of a spring are closed. Rarefaction is the region where loops of a spring are far apart. The distance between two consecutive compressions or rarefaction is called wavelength. Transverse waves. We can produce transverse wave with the help of slinky. Stretch out a slinky and move it up and down quickly. A wave in the form of alternate crest and trough will start traveling. Crest is the highest point while trough is the lowest point. In case of transverse waves, the vibratory motion of particle of the medium is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of waves. It consists of crest and trough. The distance between two consecutive crests or trough is called wavelength. The next topic is waves as carriers of energy. Energy can be transferred from one place to another through waves. For example, when we shake the stretch spring up and down, we provide our muscular energy into the spring. As a result, a set of waves can be seen traveling along the spring. The vibrating force from the hand disturbs the particles of the string and sets them in motion. These particles then transfer their energy to the adjacent particles in the string. Energy is thus transferred from one place to another place in the form of wave. Water waves also transfer energy from one place to another. Drop a stone into a pond of water. Water waves will be produced on the surface of water and will travel outward. Place a cork at some distance from the falling stone. When waves reach the cork, it will move up and down along with the motion of the water particles by getting energy from the waves. After this activity, we can say that wave is a phenomena of transferring energy from one place to another without the transfer of matter. The summary of the lesson: a wave is a disturbance in the medium which causes the particles of the medium to undergo vibratory motion about their mean position in equal interval of time. waves have two types, mechanical wave, electromagnetic waves. In longitudinal wave, the particle of the medium move back and forth along the direction of propagation of wave. In transverse wave, the vibratory motion of the particles of the medium is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of waves. Activity. With the help of Slinky, observe longitudinal and transverse waves. This is your home assignment. Question number one, how can you define the term wave? Elaborate the difference between mechanical and electromagnetic waves. Give example of each. Question number two, distinguish between longitudinal and transverse waves with suitable examples. Question number three, waves are the means of energy transfer without transfer of matter. Justify this statement with the help of simple experiment. Thank you for watching video lesson. Allah Hafiz.